very disoriented. But there's an advantage of it. When you are not prepared, you talk from your heart. When you are prepared, you actually manipulate with the words. But when you are not prepared, you talk from your heart, and that is the true communication between two people. Okay, we are talking about mental health. Now, I would like to ask from you first, what do you understand by mental health? If someone has no fever, someone's pulse rate is normal, someone has got a normal digestive system, someone is passing his excreta very well, he can sleep very well, he can eat very well, we'll say he is healthy, right? But when we will say that a person is mentally healthy, anyway. Oh, he's satisfied, okay, fine.
No anxiety.
No anxiety, okay. Anything else, please, anyone?
No kind of stress on the mind.
No stress on the mind, okay, fine, okay. Anything else, please? Obviously, there cannot be one answer to it. It's a very complex type of situation. Maybe someone who does a robbery, and he's very satisfied, right? So will we be calling him a very healthy, mentally healthy person? Okay, so let me try to give you an overview of it. Please remember that center of our mental health are our thoughts. Thoughts are in the center. And thoughts are generated in our mind. There is a बैठ जाओ बेटा जस्ट सेटल डाउन प्लीज सेटल डाउन कहीं बैठ जाओ तो सेटल डाउन प्लीज कोई नहीं जस्ट क्विक प्लीज स्क्वीज ऑन द साइड सो दैट योर कॉलीग्स कैन सेटल डाउन प्लीज स्क्वीज वेरी नाइस वेरी नाइस वेरी नाइस सी द थॉट्स आर ऑलवेज इन द सेंटर देयर इज अ ग्रेट डिबेट अमंग द फिलोसोफर्स एंड साइक यू नो साइकोलॉजिस्ट एंड पैरासाइकोलॉजिस्ट फ्रॉम वेयर थॉट्स दे कम एट अ माइक्रो लेवल एंड एन इलेक्ट्रिकल लेवल These are actually electrical circuits which are formed in our brain. And then these circuits, they generate electrical activity. And these electrical activities are then directed to a particular type of motor or sensory centers. And as a result, body behaves like this. Suddenly I got angry on this girl and I just want to, or on this boy, and I just want to slap him. So there is some thought process came in my mind. And because of that thought process, some electrical activity is generated, and that order. Thank you, sir. Welcome. So, as a result, my motor fibers of my abductors they are stimulated, and then I'm very expert in it, and I just slap on his face, right? So everything actually starts from our thought, right? So thought is on the center. But please remember. That before thoughts, we have got another ingredient which actually results in thought. And that is called Urdu ka lafz mein likhta hu ehsaas. I have got a feeling. That feelings does not have words. Feelings does not have words. It's just an impression which comes in my mind. I have got a caring attitude towards my students. I have got a vindictive attitude towards my student. I have got a revengeful attitude. I have got a sacrificing attitude. So ye ehsaas. This ehsaas results in thoughts. Thoughts have no words. They are again something in the brain. You know, thoughts results in verbal response. Verbal response then results in actions. And repeated action means habit. And at a particular circumstance, if our response is predictable, we call it, this is our behavior. Up till now, it is reversible. For example, if our behavior is bad, if we break the chain, at the level of our habit or break our chain at the level of action or maybe what we say or maybe what we think, then this is reversible. But if it crosses this line, and become irreversible, we call it personality. Not it's not changing. It's very difficult to change the personality. However, so our main talk will be revolving around these areas. Because these are reversible, and if we put an effort, we can actually control it. However, if it goes to this line, it is a very difficult and gone case. However, there's a great saying, Maulana Rumi. He has given one answer, and he says, no, personality can also be changed. Although it will be a difficult task, and in the end, please remind me if I forget, that key word which is required to change the personality. But from now onward, our talk will be confined to this. Okay? Are you with me, all of you?
Yes.
We are saying that jo gadbad hai na hamari mental health mein, jo cheez responsible hai uski, wo hamara thought process. Thought process. So please focus on thought process. Now, how this thought process is influenced? If we understand that, we will be able to control our mental health. Oh, can someone rub it for me? Don't think about me, don't think about anyone else, don't think someone who behaves very wrongly in your, amongst your friends. Think about yourself. What's your name? Huh? This talk is about Rida. What is your name? Adnan. This talk is about Adnan. So just think about yourself. Forget about the rest of the people of the whole universe. Okay? In your mind, you have got thoughts. Now, why these thoughts get wrong is because of two reasons. Number one, a structural problem. And number two, a functional problem. Structural problem is someone has an epilepsy. Someone has a space occupying the tumor. Someone has meningitis. And that resulted in damage of that particular area which was responsible for that particular thought process. Right? Now, this is not in our control. If someone had an accident and then had a personality problem, it's not our control. So, just remember that problem can be structured, but for time being, just forget about it. Then it can be functional. If you take a slide of cut section of a brain, you don't see anything abnormal, but it is not functioning properly. Now, why it can occur is because of the following reason. Genetics. Genetics do have an influence on it. Genetics. Number two, your environment. And environment means your past environment and your present environment. You were living in a home, someone was living in a home, their father and mother were quarreling all the time. Mother was abusive and father was all the time hitting the mother. Now this child has got a bad past. And that is going to be ingrained in his or her mind and going to affect her thought process. Right? Well, this is one example. Someone had a calamity. Someone had a drastic, you know, national tragedy. Some children who are born in the wartime, they develop a particular thought process. Right? Children who are born at a time when there was flood and there was some calamity and someone became homeless, they have got different type of right? And this also depends. Environment means your past training, your preconditioning, your grooming, your circumstances, and it is also present where you are working. For example, if you are working in this environment, if this environment is very hostile, it's just going to affect you. If you are someone in a marital relationship, which is a hostile marital relationship, that is going to affect. Someone has got a problem amongst their siblings, that could be a problem. In the department when you're working, if your colleagues are not really getting along with you nicely, there will be a problem. So this environment can be present. Now, can you do something about genetics? Can you change your dad or mom? that's gone. And can you change your fast? There are psychiatric techniques of going back and unearthing all those things, which are called transactional analysis. Sigmund Freud was actually father of it, and then Jung came, and then there is another person who actually they work and they actually devise the techniques where you go in your past and you dig it out and you heal it. But probably this is not in our scope. Present environment, yes, of course, we can do something. Present environment, who will change it? The political will, the administration, the school system, the education system, the administrative system, and other systems, they should just do something to change the present environment of society where we breathe. But apart from these, there is another thing, and that is your effort. As an individual, your own effort to control your thoughts. We cannot do anything about our structural problem. We can't do anything about genetics. This is not in our hand. This is also not in our hand to a larger extent. Only you can exercise it in your zone of influence. But this is something which we focus on. Your own effort to address your thought process. Lehaza, hum jis jagah par bhi converge hoke aaye hain. Ab ye sochiye, it is not the responsibility of the nature. It is not the onus is not on your parents. Onus is not on government. Onus is not on your teachers. Onus is only on you. It is your thought. It's your thought. Abhi mera haath yun jaye aur ja ke aise karke is camera ko pakad ke aur iske haath se tod ke niche phek de. Aur he gets angry with me. Can I say I did not have a control on my hand? It actually automatically went like this. I was just watching it and it did this. Will you agree with it? So how can you be agreeing to this point? I don't know why I had to kill myself. Please remember, this is your thought. Your mind is capable of generating the bad thoughts. And your mind is equally capable of generating good thoughts. Thoughts are only movie. You have opted for a horror movie. You are watching a horror movie. It's up to you to change the channel and turn on to a romantic or a comic movie or a cartoon movie. Did you understand my point? So now we are talking about your effort only to just change the channel and convert a horror movie into a cartoon movie. Watch Tom and Jerry instead of a horror movie where you have got anxiety, you've got depression, you've got suicidal thoughts, you have thoughts of anger, you have thought of frustration, you have thought of enmity, you have thought of jealousy, you have thought of destroying this whole world, you have got thoughts of blaming people, you have thought of complaining all the time, you have thought of being egoistic all the time, right? It's only in your hand. You can change it. There's no one else who can change it. The biggest problem about sorting the thought process is that we give this responsibility to others. हमारे टीचर ही इतने बुरे हैं तो हम कैसे ठीक हो? हमारी अम्मी ही हमारे साथ ऐसे सलूक करती हैं तो हम कैसे हो? मुआशरा ही इतना बुरा हो चुका है तो हम कैसे? जब लोग सड़क के ऊपर इतने फ्रस्ट्रेटेड हैं तो हमें गुस्सा क्यों ना आए? This mindset has to be taken off from head. There is only one person responsible of your bad thoughts and name of that person is Rida. And Adnan. And if you are uncomfortable with it, Javed. Okay, now next 15-20 minutes, I will just give you some tricks that how we can control our thoughts. Alright? But this will only be possible if we want to. How many of you want pleasure in your life? How many of you want peace in your life? How many of you want pleasantness in your life? How many of you want settlement of problems and not conflict. All of you want to do it. Then, if you want, if you are angry, are you pleasant or unpleasant? Why are you angry? When you are anxious, are you restless or you are in peace? Then why do you get angry? Why do you have anxious? Acha, are you, when you are depressed, are you sad or you happy?
Sad.
So why you get depressed? Just by understanding this thing, that I want peace. I want pleasantness. I want sorting out of the problems. Just understanding of this thing will actually give you positivity. Okay, now let me, where are my glasses? I just referred to you for the